Welcome to Analytics with Knox. This is another video in the Catch Up with Knox series where I'm going to talk about Power BI release February 2024. So as usual in this series, I will talk about what are the features I like, because Power BI team or Microsoft team release enormous amount of updates as part of this release, but most of them are not, we practically use it. So what are the features I'm going to use in my projects? That's what I'm going to discuss. That may be useful for most of the developers as well. And next thing is, like, I will surely make videos on the topics that I like the most in upcoming weeks. With this note, let's begin. So features are like visual calculations. This is going to be a game changer in the Power BI side, because DAX is complex and you cannot make a much complex DAX even though you are continuously learning, certain things break. But how this visual calculation is going to help to make you easier is, like, you do a calculation at within the visual itself. It will be like most of like Excel formulas. So the column A minus column B, and you want to do the running sum of this particular column. So just you can say it in simple DAX functions over here. So this is one of the visual calculation: profit equal to sales amount minus total sales. And here you can see additionally adding running sum profit. You can add this one to this one in second row, this and total of all the three in the third row. This can be achieved using this single formula here. So you can do your calculations within the visuals itself. So that is the whole concept of visual calculations, and obviously it also uses the DAX. So you no need to think of a more complex DAX, right? So it will be very simple form. So I'm definitely going to make a detailed video on this, then we can discuss much about it. Dynamic subscription for the reports. Basically, you can customize the subscription based on different users, as you can apply certain filters on that. So that is what it's all about. Till now there is no dynamic subscription. You can share the report via subscription to the specific users, but we cannot customize it much. Now we can have ability to customize. This is a feature I'm waiting for long, so I'm going to use it soon. And DAX query view improvements. So this is all about a new thing. Like November 2023, they introduced the DAX query view. Those who are viewing it for the very first time, there is another tab, or what do you call it, blade, introduced in the Power BI desktop, where you can query or practice your DAX queries. So there is a lot more improvements in that. I think it is boolean values it will accept right now, and also there are a lot of info functions introduced. So this is the feature I like the most, and I mentioned here in this release because a lot of people not aware of this, so you should aware of this as well. And the last one I like in this release is, like, TMDL, storing the Power BI file as a TMDL, which is nothing but tabular model definition language. So basically earlier they have released to store the file Power BI files in a PBIP, I think Power BI project files, and that doesn't help us to compare certain versions, right? You, from current version to previous version, if you try to compare, that is not so user friendly. But this one, which enable, has a very clear comparison. So that is why this is most preferable for development and to have a Git integrations. So these are the four features I like the most in February. So I'm going to make videos on these topics soon or later. That's it. And this channel contains a free content that covers Power BI, MSBI, and certain things on Azure Basics and SQL as well. Use this free content. And if you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and comment below for queries. Press the bell icon for notification. And let's quickly walk through the releases what I've discussed. You can see here, this is the visual calculation, these two I told about, and it is the same thing. Now you can see how it appears over here. So as soon as you add the totals, you will get different, the new meshes are automatically added in your visuals. Then dynamic subscription, dynamic per recipient subscription is now available in preview. Actually, these are things in preview. You can distribute personalized copy of your Power BI reports to each recipient. So you can see, select and filter data. You can filter based on these dynamic variables or configurations. So this is about two things I mentioned about earlier. Now let's move on to DAX Core Review. Those who are not aware of DAX Core Review, you can see here there is a new blade available. This is the report and model, table view and model view. Here you have a DAX Core Review. There is a new view. You need to enable it, still in preview feature. So there is Boolean values are accepted, and also there are a lot of additional info DAX functions are introduced. These will give you some kind of properties or internal metadata about your Power BI model. So this is the future like. And finally we have something like TMDL, right? So as you can see earlier, saving Power BIP using TMDL is currently in preview. So you need to enable this and store semantic model using TMDL format. So once you do that, so you can see here, upgrade will convert the semantic model file from TMSL, earlier it was TMSL, to TMDL. This cannot be undone. So once you saved, you cannot go back to TMSL. So that is for sure. Okay, so this is one of the thing you should aware of. So I'm going to make a proper video on this. I don't quit a very good tutorial about this. I'm going to practically implement it, then I will make a video on this topic soon. So that's it. So that's what the four topics I like the most. I hope you like this video. You can also practice it as soon as these features are available. Already it is available. You can download the latest version and you can practice it. You can comment below if you like any other features apart from whatever I mentioned. Thank you for watching, and do remember that data is your asset.